What I loved about it more than anything for me was, especially first season, it was a love story.
Yeah.
And I felt, I am a sucker for a love story. And I got to be a mother that loved her children and a good wife. And I love that I had the secret past that I was hiding, and that I got to fight and be an ex-criminal, an ex-thief. And in a way, I got to play a whole other character with my past person, which we cover in flashbacks as Anna.
You've had lots of brutal fight scenes, and you know you gotta kick some serious butt in season one.
I do to kick some serious butt on the show, which is so lucky because I'm a woman.
How do you feel about having such a strong female character in today's age of television?
I mean, I myself am a pretty strong woman and character, but it was so nice to have her still be sexy, yet not just a silly female character. Like, she was very strong. Everything she did, everything this character does, is fearless and brave. I mean, even the lying is such a risk.
Yeah.
And she thought that it would work.
Yeah, that's
right. You know, she thought that would maybe protect her family. And it all backfires, but I think her intentions are pure. I think every character's intentions are pure on our show. They have a good reason for them in their own heads, but I just don't think the rest of the world thinks so.
Reactions from fans have been great about how everything's spot on, from the casting to the writing. Did you yourself expect the sort of resonance from fans?
I think social media helps our show a lot. Yeah. And one of our executive producers, Greg Atenas, he is such a leader in social media.
Yeah.
So they find us there, and we interact with them a lot on Twitter,
yeah,
Instagram, Facebook. So you hope that the fans will find the show.
Yeah.
And it seems to me that it's really grown from when the first season aired, and we have our original Banshees, the people who watch it from the beginning.
Yeah.
And now they help promote it because they so want to support it. Plus we're kind of like, we're the David, not the Goliath.
Yes.
We're a little bit of an underdog, so they come to our support and really promote it.
Do you go online to sort of read what they say?
The first season,
yeah,
I did, which was a horrible mistake.
Oh.
But ultimately, maybe not, because you end up reading the whole spectrum of everything. Everything from I'm the ugliest woman they've ever seen, and it really bothers them watching the show, to I'm very beautiful, and everything in between.
Yeah.
So then it all ends up being zero. Beauty's in the eye of the beholder. It's whatever anyone thinks.
Exactly.
So now I feel like I'm immune to them because I've pretty much heard everything.
Yeah.
It is a genre show, and a genre show, if you don't have fans, it's not going to happen. And genre show fans are the most rabid fans, which is why we go to Comic-Con, because we want to give back to them, because we know we can't exist without them.
Yeah.
So we hoped for it. Did I expect it? I think I kind of did expect it, because I really did believe in our show. I really loved Banshee. I got it. I got what the premise was. I knew all the time that we were doing pulp.
Yeah.
You know, I'd be like, I'd flip my hair because I know that's the kind of show it is.
Yeah.
You know, it's
Like
I'm flipping my hair, I'm winking.
Yeah.
I think because of how emotionally grounded the characters are, that's why we can get away with some of the ridiculous antics that happen.
Yeah.
Because these are just ridiculously insane people. Because they have really big emotions that they express in very big ways.
How has your impression of your own character, of Anna and Carrie, evolved from season one to season two? Has she changed for you emotionally?
In season one, she was trying to keep everything together.
Yeah.
Trying to keep it together. And in season two, listen, the whole thing has blown over. So now she's trying to regain things, and the pendulum has swung both ways, and now I think it's gonna come to the middle. You know, she started as Carrie in the beginning of season one, she ended as Anna, and now it's going to be something in the middle as she tries to put her life back together.
So I know in case I'm not getting you in trouble, is there any sort of little tidbit of season two that you can share with your fans and to entice them to continue watching Banshee?
Look for episode 5. It's a very interesting, different episode for Banshee.
Okay.
It's going to reveal a lot.